Hi, and welcome to another issue of Old Steam-Powered Machine Shop. We are right in the middle of taking the Racine's hacksaw apart to kind of explore it and see what had been repaired on it and what the condition of it was. And I got it all spread out on the bench here, a lot of parts cleaned up, and looks like it's in pretty good shape, no problem. And then we had to drop everything because there's a plant up the road about 25 miles that makes industrial chain, roller chain, drive chain, stuff like that. And I got a friend that works there and as a millwright. And they had a punch press that they had just run to death. And it was a major machine in their operation, so they were in a real hurry to get it fixed. So there's the flywheel for it, and we're gonna just put that to the head of the line, and I'll show you what's gotta be done. Got a 2.5-inch bore, and the brass bushing here is completely wallowed out. I don't know how the thing ran at all, but it ran so cockeyed that the clutch dogs on the other side of this would not engage and disengage properly. And they didn't want to tear the machine down because they didn't want to stop their production. So they ran it as long as they could, and finally they decided something had to be done with it. So it's down here. So I got to get this done today. And I thought it would be interesting to just kind of follow it through. This is the stock for the bushing. It's a piece of 3-inch brass cord bearing stock. Quite expensive. It's a little less than 3 feet in diameter, so it'll fit on my press. And what I want to do is get it up on the press with engine hoist and see if I can press the bushing out. So that's the first thing. Not bad at all. About 6 ton. Indicator set up. The rough spot right there where there's a knurl on both sides of this, where it pulled it through the die, evidently. So it's a little hard to line up. But gotta take an awful lot off the OD and an awful lot off the ID, so it really won't matter. Thank you.
what I'll do is take a 60 degree cut off of this edge here so the bull nose will fit right in there. Okay, compound set at 60. I changed this to a left tool holder because it's a little more advantageous angle so that the tool won't drag when it's going through the cut. So I got the boiler fired. We just about have steam up, so we'll move over there. Well, we're in pretty good shape here. We got plenty of water. We got about 45 pounds. It'll be up to 60 in a minute. working with an old, beat up, worn out machine like this, you can't trust it. You gotta keep checking stuff. And I wanna make sure that I'm not getting any taper here. This is quite a long cut. And, 22, so that's pretty good. I made a couple of adjustments to the tailstock, making fine cuts across here, moving the tailstock over because it was cutting a little small at this end, so I moved it that way. That took care of it. Okay, getting down close. Got about one more pass and then a finish cut. This may be the last job for the little electric powered Peerless. Soon to be replaced by the Racine power hacksaw.
Device here is an injector that brings water in from the rainwater tank to fill up the seawater. So it works on the same principle as the injector. You just move water around here. Thank you.
success.